Hey, it's Job here. In this video, we are taking a look at how you can use pathfinding to create a cube that follows the player around the level. Of course, instead of cube, you can use any object you want, but we'll be using that since it's in the Start From Scratch template. But first, what is pathfinding and when you should use it? Well, normally, if you set the moving object to move towards the player, the moving object can get stuck in walls. To prevent this, you'll want to use pathfinding. Pathfinding allows the moving object to navigate around obstacles to reach the target. Let's start by opening the Start From Scratch template. Since Start From Scratch already has a cube, we need to add a player. We can add the platformer player pre-made from the asset library. Now that we have our cube and a moving player, we can start setting up the pathfinding. First, we need to create a mover type. To create a mover type, we need to navigate to the pathfinding settings by clicking Logic and then Pathfinding. You can create a new mover type by tapping the green plus icon. Mover type defines the properties of the moving object. Typically, you would make different mover types if you have different sized object that needs to use pathfinding. Optionally, you can name the mover type to make it easier to find later. Let's call this one cube. Mover type has four parameters. Radius is used for calculating how close to the walls the moving object can go and how small gaps the object can go through. At minimum, this should be the radius of the moving object. For this example, let's set that to 1. Height is used for checking how tall gaps the object can fit through. It's a good idea for this to match the height of your moving object. Climb height defines how high steps the object can climb, and climb slope defines how steep of a slope the object can climb. Once you are happy with the settings, you can go back. When you create your first mover type, the other pathfinding settings will be updated automatically, and the pathfinding area preview will be visible for the created mover type. Since our example doesn't have any unmovable objects, we need to set the area start and end positions manually. Let's set the start and end X and Z from minus 10 to 10, and Y start and end from minus 5 to 5. Now you can see that our pathfinding area preview covers the defined area. The pathfinding area is split into tiles. Changes in the game world will trigger recalculation for tiles that have changes in them. So the more tiles your navigation area has, the longer it takes for pathfinding to be calculated. Each tile is split into smaller cells. Detail size determines how many cells are in one tile. Setting the detail size to bigger makes the tile calculation faster, but it also decreases the accuracy of the pathfinding area. Detail height sets the vertical dimension for the tile cell. Now that we have set our pathfinding, let's create the logic for moving the cube towards the player. First, let's add pathfinding node from the node library. In the pathfinding node, we have many scary looking properties, so let's go through them one by one. Moving object is the object we want to move along the path. In our case, we want to move the cube, so we'll set the cube as the moving object. Target is the object we want the moving object to go to, so let's set this to be our player. Type is set to be the mover type we created previously. Moving height is the height at which the direction is calculated. Ideal height is the same as the center point of the moving object. For this cube, we want it to be 0.5. The path is made with waypoints, and waypoint radius determines the size of the waypoints, and recalc distance determines how far off the path the moving object can move before its path is recalculated. Lookup range determines how far off the pathfinding area the target object can move and still be seen. It's a good idea to increase the Y a bit, since our player can jump. Let's set that to 5. And finally, Path Lost mode determines what the moving object does if pathfinding can't find a path to the target object. When the pathfinding node is executed, or a value is read from it, it outputs the direction vector towards the waypoint in the path that leads to the target. We can use this direction vector as a force or move direction. In this example, our cube is dynamic, so let's use a force node. Now, let's set the force target to be the cube, and enable always and reset speed. Next, let's set the direction vector to use the direction from the pathfinding node, and now we are set. Let's play this to see if everything works as expected. Looks good, but we can see that the cube doesn't turn towards the player. To rotate the cube, we can use the lookup node. Simply set the cube as the target and enable lookup move direction. You can also increase the speed to make the cube rotate faster. Finally, let's add some walls so we can be sure that the pathfinding works as expected. be sure to set the wall objects to be unmovable, otherwise they won't be taken into account when the pathfinding array is calculated. Keep in mind that at the moment pathfinding array only takes unmovable objects into account. So if you have a door that's set to be dynamic or kinematic, it won't be taken into account when pathfinding array is calculated. Now when we playtest, we can see that our cube is following the player in the area and navigates its way around the walls. And that's it. If you have any questions about the pathfinding, leave them in the comments below. You can also join our Discord to get help with your game. From the description, you can find links to this example and a Learning Hub article. Thanks for watching and see you in HypeHype.